S. Levy Johnson. I was born May 16, 1942, in Columbia, South Carolina. I attended first grade at Waverly Elementary School, and my second grade year, Carver, and I attended Carver Elementary School to the seventh grade, which was segregated. In those days, there was no middle school, and so after you finished the seventh grade, you would then go to C.A. Johnson High School, and I attended C.A. Johnson High School from the 8th to the, until the 12th
because
grade.
Of segregation,
the brilliant minds in the black community could not take jobs because of segregated society. They couldn't be work for banks, they couldn't work for insurance companies, and many of the places that they work now. And as a result, most of the blacks, the best black minds, went to went on to get an education to become teachers. And so every day I had the benefit of being taught by geniuses. There was strict segregation in the school system and in every other aspect of life when I was coming up. I can recall this distinctly because I had to walk to school, that young white students would pass by me on the bus, and they called me the N-word. The dominant figure in my life was my grandfather. His name was I.S. Levy. I'm named after him. The I.S. stands for Isaac Samuel. And he went in the funeral business in 1932. So my grandfather was very active in the community, and he had a profound impact on my life, and he instilled in us a long-lasting desire, and it's part of our character to be of service to us. One of the results of having the responsibility of driving my grandfather and being his eyes because he was blind, all of those places where I took my grandfather when I was a child, those were the same places I went back to when I was campaigning. And so to a very large measure, he laid the foundation for me to get elected back in 1970. I got accepted to the University of South Carolina Law School. The significance of that was that I was the first African American in modern times to graduate from the University of South Carolina Law School, who enrolled the first day and finished the last day. I think that we as a race of people are suffering from an illusion of inclusion. We see that there is some measure of achievement. You take, for example, we have an African-American president, and a lot of people misinterpret that to mean that the masses are succeeding. A lot of people will say, you know, I.S. Levy Johnson is successful. I never accept that. Success is always a goal. It is never a status.
It's been a long time coming, but I know a change gonna come. Oh, yes, it will.